Hello, and welcome to the video tutorial on how to navigate the practice account found on the Common Application website. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a practice account. I'll also point out some of the most important components of the application so that you can better assist your students with their college application process. To start, you can access the practice application by visiting commonapp.org. Once there, select the Create an Account button in the upper right corner. From this screen, we can select from these four options. For the sake of creating a practice account, we'll select the Education Professional option so that we can see the applicant experience without being considered for admission by colleges. Your students' parents and guardians could also select the Parent or Other Adult option to create their own practice account. Now select Confirm to move on. Here we'll create login credentials for our practice account by entering an email address and password. Then we'll enter some personal information, including our name, address, and date of birth. Once all the required information has been entered, we have to review the information next to these checkboxes. The first two paragraphs determine how Common App can share your information and contact you. The last paragraph contains the terms of use and privacy policy. The first two checkboxes are optional, but you must select the last checkbox to gain access to Common Application. After checking the last box, select the Create Account button to continue. And now we can see our dashboard, which means that we have successfully created our practice account. The first thing we'll cover in the application is the My Colleges tab. If we click on it, we can see this is where a student can add any college to their application list as long as that college uses the Common Application. So now let's click on the college search link to add a college to our list so that we get a sense of what a student would see. To find the college we want, we have to enter the college or city name. For this tutorial, we'll just enter the college name of Southern Methodist University. It will appear in the results list, and we'll select the plus icon next to it. A green check mark appears next to the college name, confirming that it's been added to the college list. A confirmation message also appears at the bottom of the screen. Now let's take a look at the college we've added. We'll go to the My Colleges tab at the top of the dashboard and then select the college to view the application details. By selecting college information, we can see an overview of our college's contact information, deadlines, and required documentation. If we wanted to start the application for Southern Methodist University, or SMU, we would select the questions section here in the left-hand column. However, we're not going to complete an application in this tutorial. The last item I want to highlight on this page is the Recommenders and FERPA section. If we click on it, we'll see a message requesting that we fill out the current or most recent secondary or high school question under the Education section before Common App can send invites to recommenders. Remember this tip when advising students who are having trouble locating the FERPA release authorization or inviting a recommender. Now let's switch over to the Common App tab by selecting it near the top of the screen. Here you can see the basic information Common Application requires for any college application. We have a list of sections that must be completed. Within every section, there is a tutorial video to help students complete it. This is a great feature you can highlight in your advising sessions with students and their families. Next, if we scroll to the bottom of the profile section, we'll find the Common App fee waiver. It's good to know where this is located in case a student needs to find it. For our last task, let's go back to the Dashboard tab. From the application dashboard, students can view all their selected colleges and the status of their work for each major admission component, like the writing requirements, writing supplements, and recommendations. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Be sure to check out texasoncourse.org for more tools and resources to help your students with their college applications.